Hey guys, what's up? It's Ella. So today I'm going to do a different type of video than I usually do. So I've been thinking, so as you know, I'm a pretty big Mets fan. And so basically I've been thinking a lot about the Mets because this year they had kind of a disappointing season and they came short, but they seem to have a lot of talent and potential. So I was thinking, what could they do over the offseason to get to a level where they are in contention for postseason? And I mean, they have been kind of in contention, but I mean, like, where they could win the whole thing. So they're taking over by new management, Steve Cohen, and I think I read that he is like the will be the richest owner in all of baseball, which means that we'll have a lot of money to spend on good players so we can make a big investment this offseason, and it should be really crucial. And basically, if he's smart, then we could go far. So I was thinking, what could he do that's smart and could put us in contention? So obviously, we've already got a great team. We've got Jacob DeGrom, we've got Pete Alonso, Dom Smith, Michael Conforto, Jeff McNeil, and we've got so many others. But that's not enough, especially since last year, like, the pitching was pretty bad other than DeGrom and then David Peterson. Like, other than that, like, everybody was pretty iffy, and even Peterson and DeGrom were iffy at times because DeGrom had a couple of less strong starts, and then he scratched and missed a game because, like, I forgot why, like, a hamstring thing or something. And I decided I'm going to start by talking about pitching. So far, we're losing Porcello and Waka, which is all right. They haven't been great for us anyway. But we're definitely in the first spot in the rotation, unless he gets hurt, is Jacob DeGrom. Like, he's starting. Like, that's that. DeGrom is in the rotation. And then I say for sure we put Peterson in there because he's definitely a good person to have towards the end of your rotation. He's solid, and I think he's proven himself that last year, and I also think he's our best non-DeGrom option. So those are our only two that I think we can safely put in there, and that is not good at all. So I think what we should do is we should get Trevor Bauer in free agency. I know he'll be pretty expensive, but like I said, we have money to spend. And also, I think we should, because Trevor Bauer is going to win a Cy Young this year. Like, sorry, DeGrom, but you're not going to win this year. So I definitely think Trevor Bauer. And then I think we should also re-sign Marcus Stroman because he'll be a little expensive, but it's not crazy. And he's a solid guy, and that'll fill up the rotation almost. So we got DeGrom number one, Trevor Bauer number two, then Stroman number three, Peterson number four. And Steven Matz performed very poorly this year. He had, like, a 10 ERA. But in the past, he's had, like, a 3-4 ERA. He had a 6 ERA, like, once. But that was just once. And so I think he's proven that he can pitch. I just think he kind of forgot how this year. But since it's a 60-game season, I think it's kind of excusable. And if he's good during spring training, I think they should give him another chance. So I think I'm going to put Steven Matz at the fifth spot in the rotation. And then if he proves he can't pitch, have Seth Lugo go in. But I think for now, Seth Lugo should be in the rotation because he's proved he excels in the rotation. And I don't know if he's exactly excelled as a starting pitcher because he had some good starts, but then some pretty bad starts. Like, didn't he go two innings and let up, like back-to-back-to-back home runs and, like, 5 runs or 6 runs or something? So that was not a solid start.
So as you may know, Noah Syndergaard suffered from Tommy John surgery this year. So basically, I'm also going to talk about what I think the rotation will look like with Syndergaard when he comes back later in the year. What I said is what it's going to look like in the beginning of the year, but now this is what I think it will look like for, like, a good amount of the year. So, DeGrom's still starting off, Bauer's still second, like, assuming he's on the team. And then I put Syndergaard at number 3, Stroman number 4, Peterson number 5, and Matz to bullpen. Because I think with this type of team, like with Mats, like we can't unless he like is exceptional, we can't keep giving him opportunities and stuff because Syndergaard is better than him. So I think that Mats should be in the bullpen, and I think he can be in the bullpen. But we can't have six starters, so he could also be like a backup dude if one of them gets hurt, which with our luck, one of them will.
So now I'm going to move on to catching. So we're leaving Ramos and Chirinos. We still have Tomas Nito, but he's not a starting catcher. He's more like a backup catcher. So I would get JT Realmuto. And he will be very expensive, but like I said, we can afford to spend some money. And JT Realmuto is like the best catcher in baseball right now. And I think he would definitely help our team because he's good defensively and he can hit. He's a very solid hitter. And that would really help our team a lot, especially since we've had like a hole in catcher because Ramos in the past, he's been our starting catcher. And he's been good offensively except for this year. He had less of a good year this year, but he's never been so great defensively. And do you see him trying to throw people out at second? He almost never gets them. It's crazy, and it's so frustrating. But JT Realmuto would get them. So that's my thought process, but I think everybody's thinking like that. But I think we should definitely get JT Realmuto. I think Bauer and Realmuto should be on the top of our priority list. Then what I think we should do is I think we need a lot of relievers because I don't think we have enough relievers. Like, so, okay, so our relievers were kind of mediocre this year, and they have been in the past. I mean, we have Edwin Diaz, who is our closer, and he's been bad in the past, but he was solid this year. Jairus Familia, again, has been bad in the past, but he was good this year. We've got Seth Lugo in that spot, assuming he's in the rotation, and I think he needs to be because we're short. And then we're losing so many good people, or good enough people. Like, and then everybody else has been kind of sloppy, you know what I mean? So we need to get solid relievers. Like, I can't really think of any, but we just need more. And, like, even if I could think of some, I wouldn't be able to think of enough. So maybe they can call people up from their farm system, but they don't have a huge farm system. So I don't know, or they could, like, trade for some, or, like, I don't know, could they trade for Josh Hader? I don't think so. I don't think they'd have enough people to give away to get Josh Hader, so I don't think that's on our options. But I think we need a lot more closers, or not closers, relievers, because we have a closer, either Diaz or Lugo, depending on how Diaz plays. If Diaz pitches like he pitched at the end of this year, then I think we're good with Diaz being in there. So basically, if Diaz pitches like 2018 Diaz.
Bye, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. It's a little different, I know. And I know a lot of my viewers don't really care about baseball, but I do care about baseball. So I'm kind of making this video for me and, like, the people who do care. And if you do like these videos, you can comment down below, like, what you think I could do in the future. Assuming it lets you comment and doesn't think I'm under 13 and disables my comment for me. Just so annoying. But anyway, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you later. Bye!